and when you've been living hell to me. You blistered me since 1963. I've seen them come and go, and I've seen them die. And long ago I stopped asking why.
We're also starting to arrive out here. It is mostly media that you see behind me. But we have had a few protesters arrive, and even a few scuffles. Now, it's kind of interesting to note that Williams has not asked for a lot of the traditional ritual kinds of things that condemned inmates ask for, a final meal, last request. He's pretty much avoided all that and just wanted to talk to the visitors and kind of pray and be peaceful in his last hours.
And when I ate every inch of you, you cut me and you scarred me through and through, and I'll walk out a wiser, weaker man. Mr. Congressman, you can't understand.
My job basically is to cover the western part of the United States for Fox. I've been on the outside, and our viewers, that should be on the inside to be able to see.
We love you, Jesse!
We love you, Jesse! Judge Mathis!
In a matter of hours, former gang leader Stanley Tookie Williams will be executed if everything goes as scheduled. He is scheduled to be executed at 12:01 local time, just a few hours from now, by lethal injection for the brutal murders of four people. And I will be among a handful of witnesses who have been actually chosen as a witness to his death. The Williams lawyers are not giving up. Just a few minutes ago, we met up, but they are asking the Supreme Court to delay the execution. Just a few hours ago, Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger refused to grant Williams clemency. In a statement explaining his decision, Schwarzenegger said, quote, "Without an apology and atonement for these senseless and brutal killings, there can be no redemption."
Thursday morning, he had a meeting which promised the possibility of clemency for Stanley Williams. And not for 97 hours did he respond. He let Stanley Williams twist in the wind, tortured him for 97 hours with the hope that Governor Schwarzenegger might have the courage to rise above politics and be a human being with a heart. All of us are not only disappointed, but disgusted by this decision on the governor's part.
San Quentin, what good do you think you do? Do you think I'll be different when you're through? You bend my heart and mind and you warp my soul. Your stone walls turn my blood a little cold.
I just want to give you a hug.
$20.
No, I got $20.
I'll give you $20. You're a hug. Here, I need a talk show. Here, give me a microphone and let me make myself. Let me make an ass out of myself. And then we'll go for that. I'll give you $20.
Would you like to
go? Albert Owens.
Would you like
three? That's one. I cannot.
Why kill him 25 years later? He is no threat to society. What value is he dead? He's a trophy for some, but then he's a martyr for others. Dead, he becomes a ghost of the past, becomes alive through his works. Why try to kill killing with killing? We must feel remorse for those who were killed 25 years ago. We're all against killing and we're against violence, and we should be. We should stop easy access to guns and drugs and violence, but then do not be quick to say slam dunk on murderers. We said slam dunk in Iraq, and the slam dunk didn't quite come out that way. 122 walked off of death row, mostly because they were wrongfully convicted in the first place. So when an OJ or a Blake faces this challenge with money and dream team lawyers, they walk away.
If he were allowed to remain alive, that he'd be able to change lives, as I have been able to change lives on my journey to redemption. And so that's all we were asking, is that he be allowed to continue the work that he's been doing in recent years. We have in this country a tremendous problem with the prison industrial complex, made up 60% of black men who only represent 5% of U.S. society. Much of that is based in the root cause of hopelessness, despair, poverty, guns, and drugs being in full supply in the inner cities, while educational opportunities of quality education in short supply. And so we believe that if Tookie Williams were to remain alive, he would inspire many to drop their guns and pick up their books, just as he did, just as I did, and he would make a difference in society.
Tookie will meet God at 12:30 tonight. And it doesn't look good for Tookie. It doesn't look good for Tookie. Why can't you people be more tolerant? Why can't you people from San Francisco be more tolerant? Why can't you be more loving? Why can't you accept me for who I am? I can't help it. I'm pro death penalty. I can't help it. I'm pro death penalty. I can't help it. I was born pro death penalty. I can't help it. I'm a Christian. And I'm for the state of California to execute these people. He murdered four people. Those are the real victims here, boys and girls. Try to get your priorities in order. Tookie is nothing more than a murderer. Deal with it.
San Quentin, may you rot and burn in hell. May your walls fall and may I live to tell. May all the world forget you ever stood. And may all the world regret you did no good. San Quentin, I hate every inch of you.